In this video, we're not going to be doing anything. We're not going to be learning about networking specifically on Linux. We need to understand a few general concepts before we get to that. And so this video is going to be a sort of introduction to networking on Linux and an introduction to networking in general. So right now, you are on a computerized device watching this video, which is on the internet. And the way that's happening is basically you're connected to a router or a modem router all-in-one device, and the router is connected to your internet service provider, and your internet service provider has devices that are connected to the bigger world of the internet. So you send a request. If you open up a browser and type in google.com and then hit enter, your web browser sends that as a request. It's basically saying, okay, this is the web page that this computer wants to look at right now. It sends that through your router, which sends it to your internet service provider, and your internet service provider has all these fancy computers that that properly route certain requests to DNS servers, any request actually. And what a DNS server does is it says, okay, you gave me this string of text, a domain name or a URL, and I have a record here that shows this domain or string of text is supposed to serve up the content at this IP address. And so how the internet works is it doesn't understand google.com or facebook.com. The internet uses network addresses, right? And so think of it like each web server, each server out there has an address, just like every house on your street has an address. So if you were going to send somebody down the street to Joe's place, you would say, okay, well, go to this address. Then you would give them the address of Joe's place, and they would be able to find it. Right? The same thing is happening on a DNS server. You give the DNS server a domain name that you want to look at, and then the DNS server takes that and says, okay, well, I know this domain name is supposed to route to this IP address, so you request, you need to go over to this server to get that content. And so your request then gets translated to an IP address and other information, and it gets sent to the web server that it's supposed to be at. And then the web server, running Apache or anything really, Nginx, or I'm sure there's tons out there that I don't know about, but the web server receives your request. It receives all of the information related to it, so cookies, you know, session variables, stuff like that, as well as the exact item you want to look at. So if you go to website.com/something/something else. Everything after the .com slash is called a URI, and that indicates what piece of content on the server you want. So think of the first part, domain.com, as what server you need to be communicating with, and then afterwards, you know, /about.php or something, that's going to tell the server, once it gets the request, what page it needs to send you. And then it does its, you know, rendering process, and it sends you that page in the exact same route that your request took to get there. So it's like when you send your friend down the street to Joe's place to pick up a box of pizza. And so your friend walks down the street, he turns left, you know, maybe he turns right, he gets to Joe's place, he walks in, says, hey, I need to get a pizza. Joe gives him the pizza, and then he walks the same way back to your house, and before you know it, a web page has loaded within your computer box. And that's how that happens. I hope you guys understood that. In the next video, we're actually going to cover a few more concepts before we can dive into, you know, really understanding to the point that we can use applications to do certain things in regards to networking. So I hope you guys found that informative. If you didn't, if there's any point in this video that you felt lost or confused, or even that I was just rambling, or even if you just want to tell me, you know, a few more web server applications aside from Apache, There is a comment section to the side of this video, and you just leave a comment. I will reply. I'll get you whatever information you need, and hopefully this will make sense to you.